Hello, beloved. I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today is another day. I bring you the Word of God. Before then, we give glory, honor, and adoration to our Lord Jesus Christ for how far He has brought us. We give Him all glory, all honor, all adoration. We thank Him for His provisions. We thank Him for His guidance. We thank Him for taking care of us all the time, in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you, Lord, for the gift of life today, and we bless your holy name, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Now, whatever the state of your relationship with the Lord, be assured that He wants something closer and more meaningful. God desires a connection so deep and strong that words like friendship and fellowship cannot fully describe it. He created us for intimacy. Of all the creatures on earth, human beings are the only ones made in God's image. Like Him, we can think, reason, feel, and make choices, though we do none of these things as fully or perfectly as He does. The attributes that separate people from the rest of creation equip us to relate to the Lord in a unique way. Jesus called His followers friends. Now, let's quickly go to the Bible and read a quick example in John 15 verse 15. Henceforth, I call you not servant, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth. But I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father, I have made known unto you. So now, and Paul also wrote that believers are sons of God. And we can find that one too in Galatians 4 verse 7. And it read, Wherefore, thou art no more a servant, but a son, and if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. So, those are not distant, impersonal relationships. When we spend time with the Lord, we grow as close to Him as a beloved child to a father. Some believers have the mistaken idea that doing something Christian is the way to make God happy. But the way to please our Father is by being Christian. He wants us to live in such a way that others see He is our Father and best friend. Let's quickly read something from Psalm 103. Verse 1 to 22, but because of time, we are going to take it from 1 to 10. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. Who forgiveth all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfieth thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord executeth righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. He made known His ways unto Moses, His acts unto the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. He will not always chide, neither will He keep His anger forever. He hath not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. Now, for most of my life, I believed that the Heavenly Father and I shared a relationship for my benefit. However, His primary purpose for creating intimacy with believers is to reveal Himself. I pray that the Lord will reveal Himself to you intimately, help you, guide you to understand His Word, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.